just the summation of n, and then we have midterm 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And then for max terms, so how did we define max terms? So again, max terms, they have all the variables in a function, either in the regular form or complemented form, and then we use capital letter for representing max terms. So we say M0 through M7 for the case that we have three variables, and here we just take the variables and we are going to order them together. So these are the midterms and max terms that we defined last time. So for the max term expansions, so instead of using this A plus B plus C, we can replace it with M0, right? So the reason that we are doing that is that we can express the product of some form of the function in terms of m's rather than writing them. So then we have the product, right? So that's equivalent to this, just a product of m, 0, 1, 2, and so on for this function. So that was the maxim and midterm expansion of functions.
Can you go back for a second?
Sure.
I have a question. Does it mean that for mean terms we assume that A, B, C are like initially 1?
So what is it?
Yeah.
The mean terms are what? Yeah, those are the regular functions are 1. That's how we do the mean terms, right? So are you talking about the truth table?
Yeah, look, for example, the first line is A prime, B prime, C prime, right?
Yeah.
That means, and the values of A, B, C is 0, 0, 0.
Right.
So that means that, like, we assume that A, B, C, all of them are equal to 1, right? And for max terms, we assume that A and B and C, the values of A, B, and
so
C is
0. 0, 0, 0, so that's going to be 0. See? Let's go and make up an example. So, suppose we have A, B, C. So, this is our function. And let's define it with this. Okay? So, from this, we want to write the minterm expansion and max expansion. So, we want to write the sum of product form and product of sum form. So our function f of a, b, c, the way that we did it, in order to write the midterm, we go to where our function is 1, right?
Right.
And then it's going to be 1, a prime, b prime, c.
So this is true only if a is equal to 0, b equal to 0, and c equal to 0,
yes.
Right?
So if your function is defined to be 1 for that input combination. So what you have is a black box.
Yeah, yeah.
And this is your function. So you are saying if I apply here 0, 0, 0, I'm going to get 1. Right? So you are trying to represent this behavior of your function with some representation. So one representation is sum of product form. That we go and write this. Then next one is going to be A prime, B, C prime. Next one is going to be A prime, B, C. Next one is A, B, C prime, and so on. So now for the product of some form, okay, then what can we write? It's going to be A plus B plus C prime.
Yeah, you see in this case we assume that A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0, and C is equal to 1. So it's like exactly the opposite.
Right. So then we want our function to be 0 if we apply this to it. So we write this one, and this is 0 as well, so it's going to be A plus A prime plus B plus C prime, and then this one also, which is A prime plus B prime plus C prime.
Okay.
So now, so midterm, these are all midterms, the way that we have defined midterm. So then we say instead of representing it like this, this term is going to be M0, right? Plus, and this is going to be 0, 1, 0, which is 2. So it becomes M2. Plus, this is going to be 0, 1, 1, which is 3. And then this one is 1, 1, 0, which is 6. So this is another representation of this sum of the form of the function. Same thing for this one. This is going to be what? Max term number 1 ended with max term number 4. And then max term number 5 and then 7. Okay? So these are just representation of function.
Okay. Thank you.
Did that help? And then another notation that we can use for sum of product form is if we have this one, we can write it as summation of n of 0, 2, 3, and 6. And this one we can write it as product of m, 1, 4, 5, and 7. Okay, so these are just notations to make things easier. So the concept of max term expansion and min term expansion is that instead of writing these terms, we want to replace it with this n.
And subscript starts with from 0, right?
What is that?
Well, that subscript,
yes,
from 0.
Through N7.
Okay.
Let's take a look at an example that we want to find minterm expansion of a function that they have given us. So in this problem, we want to find the minterm expansion of this function. We have a, b, c, d. So we have four variables. A prime times B prime plus B plus A C B prime. So minterm expansion. So what are the requirements for our minterms? How did we define it? We should have all the values, right? In just regular form or complemented form. So here our function has what? Four variables, right? So here, if we, let's multiply this up, a prime b prime plus a prime d plus a c d prime. So this term is not a minterm, is it? No. So what variables are missing in it?
C
and d. In this one, what are we missing there?
B
and c. This one is missing b, right? So now, somehow, we have to introduce this. So that all the terms, they have minterms. They are representing minterms. So for first one, let's do this. So we have A prime, B prime, and then C plus C prime. That's just one, right? So if I add this with C plus C prime, I haven't changed anything because that's just one. Same thing I'm going to do for D. D plus D prime. So I haven't changed my term. But now by doing this, I'm introducing all the variables. And then I will have minterms. Like this one. What is this missing? B, so I take that, and then C plus C prime to introduce the C, and then D. And then in this one, we are missing what? B. So B plus C prime, D. So then we can multiply this out and then get our minterms. So multiplying this out, what do we get? We get A prime, B prime, C. Plus A prime, B prime, C prime, D plus D prime. Let's multiply that as well. So we're going to get A prime, D, B. I'm going to multiply this together. A prime, D, B prime. And then this whole thing is going to be multiplied by C plus C prime. And then we have what? Multiply that out. So we get A, B, C, D prime. Plus A, B, prime B prime C D prime plus A prime B prime C prime D plus A prime B prime C prime D prime. And then multiplying that out, we get A prime B C D plus A prime B C prime D. And then we have A prime B C prime D. And then that's going to be A prime B prime C prime. And then D. Okay. So these are the terms that we got, right? So now all these that we have, all these terms that we have, are they mean terms? By definition of mean terms. If they are mean terms. Because our function has four variables, and each of these terms, they have four variables, either in complemented form or regular form. Okay? So now we want to write this in M notation. So let's see how we can do that. So if we have the not of the variable, that means it's 1, 0, so 0, then 1, 1. So that's going to be 1, M3.
3.
Then for this one, we have 0, 0, 1, 0, that's 2. Then we have 0, 0, 0, 1, that's 1. And then this is all 0s. And here we have 0, 1, 1, 1, which is 7. And then this is 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. And then this term is 0, 1, 0, 1. This one is 0, 0, 0, 1. So then we can write this in M notation. We can write it from A, B, C, D. It's going to be, so we have 0 here, so let's write it. It's going to be M0 plus M1. Then we have 2 here.
Yeah.
So we have M1, 2 of them, so we just write 1. M2 we do have, and then M3 we have. And then this is going to be 5, so we have M5. So we got these two, and then that's 7, right? So then in sigma notation, this is just equivalent to summation of M of 0, 1, 2, 3, 5, and 7. So this up. So any function that they give us, we can express it in terms of its minterms. So we can expand it to minterm expansion. And
so general multiplication is set up as where you have A prime, B prime, C plus A prime, B prime, C prime, and all that in parentheses times D plus D prime. Were you doing, because I understand D times A prime, B prime, C is A prime, D prime, C.
So here, let's do it again.
Just how multiply out how much times?
C plus C prime, then do something. And then D plus, or let me do it. Okay. So we have A prime, B prime, C plus A prime, B prime, C prime. So that's the first form.
Yeah.
And then times D plus D prime. So then multiplying this out, we get A prime, B prime, C, D plus A prime, B prime, C, D prime, plus A prime, B prime, C prime, D, plus A prime, B prime, C prime, D prime. So you need to multiply this by that. This by that, and this one by this, and this one by this.
Okay, all right, you just put a bit of place in my mom would see himself.
Sure.
Okay, thanks. Thank you.
Okay, so now the same expression, let's take it and express it in maximum expansion. So do maximum expansion. That, so again we have f of a, b, c, d, which is a prime times b prime plus d plus a, c, d prime. So now this time we want to do maximum expansion of this. So what form should we have it? We should have parentheses multiplied together, right?
So
that comes from, and inside each parenthesis, what do we need to have? All the values. Okay, so in order for me to do that, what we need to do is factor this, right? So factoring this, how do you all want to factor this? So you have A prime and A, right? So we have, if you have X and X prime, then if you have Y and Z, what is that going to be equal to? It's going to be X multiplied by whatever you have there, and then so it's going to be XZ plus X prime Y, no? Okay, so here we have A and A prime, so this is, this can be my X, this can be my X prime, and then this can be my Y. We can call that to be Y inconsistent, or Z to be consistent with I have what I have there, and then Y to be this. Okay, so then we just apply that. So we get A prime plus, what am I going to get here? Whatever I have here, CD. And then A plus whatever we have there. And then again, I'm not done yet, right? I have to, again, factor this out. So then we have A prime plus C times A prime plus C prime.
Can't we do that order?
What's that?
Can't we do it in that order?
What do you mean?
Where you factor it out first and then you split it up smaller, or can you split
it
up smaller
ways
and
that
factor it?
You, there are different ways of factoring or multiplying.
So it doesn't matter which
so
order.
So if you are following the rules correctly, and you're applying the theorems correctly, then you're fine.
Okay.
So there is not only one way of doing this. Okay, so then this is this. Now we have a product of some form, right? Yeah, product of some form. But if are these terms that we have here maximums?
No.
They are not by definition. So in this one, what are we missing?
B and D.
B and D. So how can we introduce them? We say this is BB prime plus C plus BD prime, right? Because BB prime is just zero. You can add it. It's not going to change it. CC, DD prime is the same, zero. You can add to it. So that way we can introduce the terms which are missing. So we have A prime plus DB prime plus CC prime plus D prime. And then in this one, we are missing C. So let's add the CC prime. Right, so then after doing that, now we have to transform this back to the what, to the form that we have only one variable, right? So we have to factor it again. So factoring this, we get A prime plus B plus C plus DD prime. I'm breaking this one down first. So A prime plus B prime plus C plus DD prime. And then this one, let's break this one down again. So we get B plus CC prime plus D prime. And then we have A prime plus B prime plus CC prime plus D prime. And then this one we can break the CC prime, so C plus D times A plus D prime plus C prime. Okay, so these are okay. They are max terms, but these are not yet. So again, we have to go through this process again to factor this one. So we get A prime plus B plus C plus D times A prime plus D plus C plus D prime. A prime plus B prime plus C plus D. A prime plus B prime plus C plus D prime. And now, under this one, now we can do that. So A prime plus B plus C plus D prime. A prime plus B plus C prime plus D prime. And then we have the rest of it. A prime plus B prime plus C. D prime. Any question up to this point? Do we have followed? So now we want to see what max terms these are. Okay? But this is opposite to the other one. So A prime is going to be 1. Okay? So we have 1, 0, 0, 0. Then we have 1, 0, 0, 1. We have 1, 1, 0, 0. We have 1, 1, 0, 1. And then this is going to be 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, what do we have? What is this one? NH, right? That's just eight. And this is what? Nine. This is 12, right? And this is 13. And then that's 9, we already got that. Then 1011, what is that? 11. 1101, what is that? 13 that we have. Okay. Then 15. And then this is 4. And then we have 6. And then another way of expressing this is just the product of M of this number. So 6, 4, 6, and then we have 8, 9, 11, 13. So any function that they give us, we can do maximum expansion and minterm expansion and express it in terms of minterm and max. We want to this function f of ABC is given to us. We want to we want to express F as a minterm expansion, use M notation. So then, what should I do here? So we want to express it as minterm expansion. So what form should we be? Sum of product. And so we need to multiply this out in order to get in the minterm expansion. So then multiplying out, what do we get AB plus A prime B times C plus C prime. Multiply this out, we get A prime B C, A prime B prime C. Multiplying this out, we get ABC plus AB C prime plus A prime B C, A prime B C prime. So now do we have midterm expansion?
Yeah.
We do have it. All the terms, they have all the variables and either in just the variable or the complement. Okay, so now we need to figure out, express this in summation notation they're asking us to do. So then this is 111, 110. 011, 010, 011, 001. So what term are these? F of ABC is going to be summation of we have 1, 2, 3, and then 5, and 6. Now, they're saying express F as max term expansion.
Sorry, is the second term, isn't that a 6?
Might be. Oh, this is 6. Okay, so then express f as a max term expansion. So whatever numbers which are not in the minterm are going to be in the max term, right? So then if we have a function, so the f of abc, the max term expansion of it, the exponential product of n, so 0 is not there, so it should be here. Then we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 should be here, 5 should be here, and then 6 and 7 are there. So by looking at that, we can write what the max term expansion. So whatever minterms are not in the minterm expansion, then those numbers are going to be in the other one, in the max term expansion of the function. So then, next part of the problem, they're asking express f prime as a minterm expansion. So now we want to do minterm expansion for f prime. So let's enter this function into a truth table and then we can see it better. Let's do that. So we have ABC. Okay, so then our function was this. That's how they defined it. So we have minterms at 1, 2, 3, 6, and 7. And then maxterms are going to be 0, 4, and 5. So that's our function. And then we can calculate f prime. F prime is going to be 1. So what happened here? Whatever is the maxterm for that one is going to be minterm for this one. Whatever is the minterm for this one is going to be the maxterm for that one, right? So then, from that, now, if we want to write the minterm expansion for f prime, what is that going to be? To equate with summation of n of 0, 4, 5, right? And then, as minterm expansion for f prime, so suppose we want to express f prime as a max term expansion. So then f prime, ABC, is going to be the product of m. And now, what are those numbers? 1, 2, 3, 6, 7. Okay, so that's what we are learning. Right? So f and f prime, mean terms for f are going to be max terms for f prime, and max terms for f are going to be mean terms for f prime. Any question on that? Okay, another thing that we can do with this max term and minterm expansion is to use it to show equalities. So if they give us an equation, they want us to show that one side is equal to the other side. They can do minterm or maxterm expansion for both sides, and if they are the same, we have proved that we have an equality. Okay, so let's look at an example of that. So we want to show that A prime C plus B prime C prime plus AB is equivalent to A prime B prime plus BC plus AC prime. Okay, so let's, how about if one of you come and do this one? So we want to take this side, do a minterm expansion on it, take this side, do a minterm expansion on it, and then show that they are both the same. Everyone is going to help you, so come to the board and do it. So first of all, how many variables do we have in this equality? We have A, B, C, right? Oh. So then, all these, they're missing a variable, right? So we need to introduce it. students write the left hand side and right hand side separately, and then do them. And then for the other one, we get plus B prime C prime times A prime plus A. And then we have the plus. One thing that you should be careful here, when you get to this point, you want to make sure that you have A, B, C in all of them. So if you don't, then your numbers are not going to be good. So then rewrite it as A, B, C. So the first one is going to be A prime, B, C. I'll just... That one is A prime, B prime, C. Let's see what numbers those are.
So we have
0, 1, 1. For next one, we have 0, 0, 1. Next one is 0, 0, 0. Next one is 1, 0, 0. Then 1, 1, 1. 1, 1, 0. Okay? So now let's do the same thing to the other side. So the other side is C is missing, so it's going to be A prime, B prime times C plus C prime. Next, you can write as A plus A prime in parentheses. A plus A prime times BC plus A, then parentheses, B plus B prime. If you write it this way, then you don't have to do that exercise. So then you have A prime, B prime, C plus A prime, B prime, C prime, plus A, B, C, plus A prime, B, C, plus A, B, C prime, plus A, B prime, C prime. So let's see what numbers we have on this side. So 0, 0, 1. Then we have 0, 0, 0. Then that one, 1, 1, 1. 0, 1, 1. And then 1, 1, 0. And then the other one is 0, 0, 0, 0.
It's 1,
0. It is 1, 1,
0, 0.
Okay, so are they the same? Or are they different? That's a question. So do we have the same numbers? So let's write it in M notation, but write summation of M, and then parentheses, summation of M, and then we have, and 0 is the 0, comma 1, and then we have 3 sims, and then 4, 6, and 7. Do we have the same numbers on the other side? So that's summation of M going from 0, 1, so we have 0, 1, 3, 4, 6, and 7. So they are 6 and 7. Okay, so as you can see, this is another way of showing for equality. So let's stop here and then we'll continue with the rest of this on Monday. So Monday